morning to everyone. Let us start today with the sound understanding of the osteology of the, rather the skull, which has been already talked in the what 4-5 episodes on the skull. The skull is the one which is meant for to hold and to protect the brain and other sense organs in almost all the vertebrate animals. So it means all the vertebrate animals have got the water skull in order to hold and in order to protect the sense organs and as well as the water that of the brain. Once you know this, with having that all the sound understanding of osteology of the skull, its internal, its everything. And skull is a formed by the what irregular flat bone by means of joining each other by means of the sutures, where it can give the protections. So with having that sound understanding, we will go to the what beginning of or an introduction to the neurology. To understand that neurology or neuroanatomy, one must know little bit apart from the what that of the neurology or the neuroanatomy, a biological point of view, what is the meaning of organism? Organism is nothing but it is a collection of the what small cells which are performing the same function and the almost all same structure. They together forms of what tissues. Tissues in turn forms the system. System of many, they together form so what is said to be as an organism. This is called now this organism of any type, either it may be the what unicellular, or two you will be having bicellular, or it be a multicellular. So humans are, or rather what you say, organisms, when you take which are having a what complex systems, they are said to be what is said to be as a what multicellular, right from the amoeba, and here you will be having what is said to be as the other things, other phyla in the biological point of view. Now this organism, so every organism in the what universe, they have got a total dependency, means the dependency of the organism upon the what that of the environment. Now this environment on which all the organism which you will be surrounding by the what very many environments, the meaning of saying the organism is dependency of the water, that of the organism, is upon the what environment, where thereby you have got the different types of the water responses. So if that you can say response will by the organism, where it will be going to stay, if it is good, the organism will be enjoying its stay in the environment. Then if, as because that you can say the dependency of the organism is on the environment, if it is little bit uncomfort, then it will be not satisfied. So, this type, the reaction of the organism totally depends on the water, that of the, or you can say, environment or the circumstances where that organism is staying. So, that type of the response you will be going to get by the what organism, as because it is depending on the what, upon the what environment. So this mechanism, it is totally by the what, that of the, you can say, a protective mechanism of the organism which is totally performed by one system, that which is executing in the organism by the central nervous system. Central nervous system. Now this central nervous system, what is it? It will be having a, what is said to be as comparing with transformation processing communication with controlled system of homeostasis. Homeostasis system or mechanism . So the meaning of this, each organism is not same. It will be having a different
pattern that can be compared. And the method that what it will be going to transform or giving a reaction depends upon responses. In order to have, there will be a water processing system in the organism. Then it can communicate, it can transfer in such a way that what it will be transferring, the informations, it should be in a controlled system. That is what is said to be as many things. Homeostasis system or homeostatic system or mechanism. Now when the homeostatic comes, it can compare with the water thermal. That is called as a water thermal change. Or it can be temperature change, or it can be a water that of the anything in the system. When the thing is going on, there will be a water production of the water energy. So in that connection, the homeostatic mechanism of the water, that of the organism, totally depends upon the water environment, where it stays, and then the response by that organism it can have. So this is what the thing. Now, coming to the water, that I think you can say controlled system. Controlled system. So it can control, it's, you can say, the processing or the transformation of the water, that of the informations, in a coded pattern. So that will be the work done by this organism under the water, neuroanatomy or neurology. Now these are all things, it will be going to carry on by the one thing called as a water neuron. Now what are the neurons? Neurons are the functional unit. Functional unit of the water, neuroanatomy or the neurological field or a nervous system. Now this you can say neurons, they will be going to get what it does then. These neurons are of a water type, unique polar neurons. Second, by polar neurons, then multipolar neurons. Now these polar means those are the endings of the neurons. So if you want this, the particular pattern, how they are and all in Gray's anatomy, it will be there in 7.5 A2E with 1 to 15, 1 to 12
picture diagrams, so you can refer how those things are there. These are called as about neurogeometry like diagram, neuro or neuronal geometry, neuronal geometry. So these things are the there, not only in the water, that of the only the brain, not only the water, but also in the water, that of the spinal cord. Also in the water, any of the, you can say, nerves, either the peripheral or the water, cranial, everywhere it will be there. Now these neurons, what they do? These neurons are meant for the insertions. Of the what message, then interrogations, interrogation means question. Organism will be multicellular or bicellular, will not accept as it is, it can have a response mechanism, it can react. So they have all the interrogative tactics. Apart from that, it does the water transformations. Transformation. What it does, what it transforms. And it also onward transformation. Transformation of coded informations. Coded informations. So what that main thing will be going to order the same way, with the same code, with the same question, it can transform for the further neurons. So these things are perfect. Now, thing is what? Now these all things are carried out by this neuronal message. Now what? Is it one neuron can do? No. There are many more. Or millions of neurons in neuroanatomy or in the neurological fields. Now the question, how that thing it will be going to process, how that thing can be kept, that message or that informations will go through synapse. Synapse. Now these synapses, now the question, what is the meaning of synapse? Synapse is nothing but it is a union between the one neuron to the another neuron, either which is situated little distance or little far or more far. So this is called as a synapse. Now these synapses, how they occur? These synapses, to understand, you should know the model of the neurons. So this is the model of the neuron.
neuron. So you have what this is called the body, and these are called the projections. Now these projection, out of that one is a long, this is called the axon, and these are called the water dendrites. Now the dendrites are the what they are the information collecting matters. So they are the sensor. So they collect the information of any kind, either by the water, homeostatic, that is what the temperature or the energy, whatever that thing, after getting the system working. Axon of the water motor, they are the long, they go to the water place of action. So this is what, how the thing, now to understand better way, the axon, the dendron of one uniting with the water dendron of the neighboring one. To become a what? A dendrodendronic synapse. This is the first. Then the water dendron of one uniting with the water that of the axon of the water, another neuron. So this is called as a dendroaxonic synapse. This is the second. Axon of one uniting with the water axon of the another. So this will be the what axonic synapse. Then the permutation and the combinations of these also may occur. So those are called as the water synapses. Now, what is the, you can say, dimension of this particular neuron? The neuron dimension is length, breadth, thickness. Length, if you have taken, they are meters together. Meters together. Because it is coming from some and goes into the water longer. So these are the things. Now these synapses, what they do? These synapses will be going to do some, even you can say, produces the inhibitory circuits. Circuit means it is a one arc, how you have got in the electrical field. So there are circuits that is called as feed forward inhibition. Second, feedback inhibition. Then the third, that is C. You have got, that is what is circuit here, lateral inhibition. This lateral inhibition is also called as inhibitor surrounded inhibition. So inhibitor surrounding means around this synapse. What are all the things that there, the cells, arteries, veins, then the what's that of the CSF, yeah. CSF is the what?
have a limb, but that is replaced by the what?
CSF, cerebrospinal fluid. So those are the things that what you will be going to have. Those are called as vascular inhibitions. So these things it will be. Now after having had, now these things what you get, they are very important. Very important. Now after having had this, in the water that of the river you can say, neurology or the neuroanatomy, you have got some types of the water that of the, some types of the water, neurons apart from this, unipolar, bipolar, multipolar, those are called as a water. Those are called as neuroglias. Neuroglias. These neuroglias are there specially in the water, covering of the water that of the cavities. Coverings of the cavities in the brain and spinal cord. These you can say neuroglias covering what is that? This is called the what is epidermis. Those are there in that. They come specially when disease will be there of this, if any collection in the what cavities of the brain and the spinal cord becomes these cells, ependymal cells, proliferates. Producing gliosis. Gliosis. So at that moment his neuroglias are present. Then you have got the water that of the pitocytes. Now these pitocytes are called as the astrocytes. These astrocytes are there at the what that of the you can say endothelial cells. Which are there in the what gap of vascular sinuses, in the Müller cells. These Müller cells are present at the retina of eye. Oh, Then you have got the pure name, what is said to be as epidymium. Cells. These ependymal cells are also called as tanyocytes. They are present in the what ependymal and astrocytes. And the ependymal astrocyte in the brain and spinal. So these things will be there, especially when other than the water, these things they are there. But these are all ependymal cells, Müller cells in the eyes, neuroglias. Then you have the astrocytes. Then apart from that, there are some, they are also present, they are called as a what? Oligodendrocytes, that is the fifth. Oligodendrocytes. These oligodendrocytes, they are there. Especially when there will be a degenerative disease is going on. Degenerative disease is going on at the level of the water that of them by the so where you will be going to have a neuromuscular junction, where that axon will be going to, and at that point these things are there. So especially in the myasthenia gravis, that is the neuromuscular disorder, so it might get into this oligodendrocytes. So these are the things that what you should know about. Then you will be going to get the what? How, with having this all sound understanding, how this you can say neurology has to be studied? The neurology has to be studied. Includes brain, spinal cord, cranial nerve. Now in the brain, you have got a forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Midbrain is called, forebrain is called as a proencephalon.
So brain is called the encephalon. Midbrain is called the mesencephalon. Hindbrain is called the wrong encephalon. Wrong encephalon. RHO. Wrong encephalon. Now this is the brain. All these three parts. Inside they have got the cavity. Inside there will be a cavities. Those cavities are lateral ventricle of brain, third ventricle of brain, fourth ventricle of brain. Cavity means ventricles. Parts, forebrain, midbrain and hind. They are there, all these cavities. This cavity includes, or this cavity has got what is known as cerebrospinal fluid and the covering of brain, especially pia matter and the blood vessels. So this has to be done. Then you have got a spinal cord. Spinal cords, you have to be in that, you have to be in the central canal. In that central canal, definitely pia mater, CESF, it will be there, and then cover. A pia mater CSF, blood vessels. Blood vessels. Then you have got the these cranial nerve, 12 pairs of cranial. They are ranging from olfactory nerve, optic nerve, oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve, trigeminal nerve, abducens nerve, facial nerve, glossopharyngeal nerve, 10th vagus nerve, 11th accessory nerve, 12th hypoglossal. These are the 12 pairs on each side. Then we have got the spinal nerve. They are 31 pairs. They are 31 pairs. Now these 31 pairs, cervical 8, thoracic 12, lumbar 5, sacral 5, coccygeal. So like that you have to deal. So this is what the thing one has to do. And apart from that, the
covering of brain and the spinal cord and deep covering of 12 pairs of cranial and 31 pairs of spinal. They are covering of brain and spinal cord is called the meninges. And the covering of that of the, you can say 12 pairs of the motor cranial and 31 pairs of spinal, they are called the meninges. With this, the introduction of the word that of the, you can say, neurology or the neuroanatomy, or in short, because it has been already learned when you were there in the what higher secondary school days and even the PUC 1 and PUC 2, that is what 11th and 12th standards. Those who are coming for the what even after graduation in BSc, it will be there. So there is no need to go further in to that detail. So it is called as a what introduction to the field of neurology, neuroanatomy or nervous system. Considering neuroanatomy for anatomy, neurology for anatomy and nervous system, especially for physiological field, how it acts with one understanding. Now whatever the message traverses through and through the neuron via the synapse, that message is called as neuro message. As it is traveling from one neuron to the another neuron, the same may be told as neurotransmission. Information has to be transferred, it will be transferred, communicated, control system, okay. So like that, it will be the thing. Thank you one and all for hearing this talk on introduction of the what neurology, neuroanatomy and as well as the what central nervous system or nervous system. Thank you one and all.